The proposed facility would replace the cold, wet weather mat program, which loses its funding in the upcoming spring. But with the shelter on 3030 Gordon Avenue at least a couple years away, one man and the Hope for Freedom Society is trying to fill the gap that would be left for the homeless.
There was some considerable angst about the fact that it was a container-based thing, and people didn't like that particular format. So we worked on that and what that image looked like. So we developed what I'm calling a container village concept. These three buildings here are converted shipping containers. They're converted to have little rooms in that area, and that's where the homeless would sleep at night.
But Port Coquitlam's mayor says the interim shelter wouldn't work in his city, which houses the majority of Tri-City's homeless.
Well, there was two things. One, they asked if we had any land to house these containers, and we just don't in Port Coquitlam. We don't have anything that's zoned appropriately or even has services. I think there's also other solutions that we could look at, such as extending, getting additional funding so that we can continue in the churches and do the cold weather mat program in the churches.
Rob Thiessen thinks the mat program has outgrown its purpose.
It was suggested initially it was going to be a two-year program, and then now it's a four-year program, and I think at some point in time we need to step up and move beyond that.
And stepping up is what Thiessen will be doing until the homeless in the Tri-Cities have a permanent home. Shahid Devji in Coquitlam for BCIT Magazine.